And come, you know, secrets are hid, plans and thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Alleluia. Christ our Passover has been sacrificed for us.
Therefore, let us keep the feast,
not with the old leaven, the leaven of malice and evil, but with the unleavened bread of sincerity and truth. Alleluia. Christ, being raised from the dead, will never die again. Death no longer has dominion over him. The death that he died of sin once for all. But the life he lives to God. So also consider yourselves dead to sin and alive to God in Jesus Christ our Lord.
Alleluia.
Christ has been raised from the dead, the first fruits of those who have fallen asleep. For sin by man came death, by man has come also the resurrection of the dead. For as Adam all died, so in Christ shall all be made alive. Alleluia. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. O God, who have taught us to keep all your commandments by loving you and our neighbor, grant us the grace of your Holy Spirit, that we may be devoted to you with our whole heart and united to one another with pure affection, through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
The first reading this morning is from Acts. While Peter was still speaking, the Holy Spirit fell upon all who heard the word. The circumcised believers who had come with Peter were astonished that gifts of the Holy Spirit had been poured out even on the Gentiles, for they heard them speaking in like tongues and extolling God. Then Peter said, "Can anyone withhold the water for baptizing these people who have received the Holy Spirit, just as we have?" So he ordered them to be baptized in the name of Jesus Christ. Then they invited him to stay for several days. The word of the Lord.
And thanks be to God.
Psalm 98, set in half verse, "Sing to the Lord a new song.
For he has done marvelous things.
With his right hand and his holy arm,
he has won himself the victory.
The Lord has made known his victory.
His righteousness has been shown in the sight of the nations.
He remembers his mercy and faithfulness to the house of Israel.
And all the ends of the earth have seen the victory of our God.
Shout with joy to the Lord, all your lands.
Lift up your voice, rejoice, and sing.
Sing to the Lord with the harp.
With the harp and the voice of song.
With trumpets and the sound of horn.
Shout out joy before the King, the Lord.
The land and those who dwell therein, let the rivers clap their hands.
And let the hills ring out in joy before the Lord, when he comes to judge the earth.
In righteousness shall he judge the world.
And the peoples with equity.
The second reading is from John. Everyone who believes that Jesus is the Christ has been born of God, and everyone who loves the parent loves the child. By this we know that we love the children of God when we love God and obey his commandments. For the love of God is this, that we have, we obey the commandments, and his commandments are not burdensome. For whatever is born of God conquers the world. And this is the victory that conquers the world of faith. Who is it that conquers? the world, but the one who believes that Jesus is the Son of God. This is the one who came by water and blood, Jesus Christ, not with the water only, but with the water and the blood. And the Spirit is the one that testifies, for the Spirit, the truth, the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The author of the Battle Hymn of the Republic.
who, sickened by the casualties of the Civil War, make pleas to mothers everywhere to call for and act for peace, that their sons might no longer be lost in the futility of war. St. Julian of Norwich thought of God and of Christ as a mother, as one who birthed us. There's a canticle in Enriching Our Worship, which is a supplement to the Book of Common Prayer. And if you did not know it, yesterday was Julian's feast day. The canticle is called A Song of True Motherhood, and its words are from Julian. God chose to be our mother in all things, and so made the foundation of his work most humbly and most pure in the Virgin's womb. God, the perfect wisdom of all, arrayed himself in this humble place. Christ came in our poor flesh to share a mother's care. Our mothers bear us for pain and for death. Our true mother, Jesus, bears us for joy and endless life. Christ carried us with him in love and travail until the full time of his passion. And when all was completed and he had carried us so for joy, still all this could not satisfy the power of his wonderful love. All that we owe is redeemed in truly loving God. For the love of Christ works in us. Christ is the one whom we love. This image of Christ as mother is not unique to Julian. Jesus himself in the gospel compared himself to a mother hen who longs to wrap her wings around her children. The Psalms also contain many images of God as mother, who nurtures and suckles her child at her breast. In today's gospel, we hear Jesus say to his disciples, "As the Father has loved me, so I have loved you. Abide in my love. If you keep my commandments, you will abide in my love, just as I have kept my Father's commandments and abide in his love. I have said these things to you that my joy may be in you and that your joy may be complete. This is my commandment, that you love one another as I have loved you. No one has greater love than this, to lay down one's life for one's friends." I do not know too many friends with a love so strong that they would lay down their life for their friend. But I can think of many examples where a mother might have been. And it isn't at our own mother's knee that most of us learned of love. I say most of us because, unfortunately, there are examples of mothers who neglect or even abuse their children. Yet most mothers lay down their lives from the moment their children are born, setting aside their own needs in order to nurture, protect, and care for their children. It's why this holiday, Mother's Day, is so popular, and not just here, but in many countries throughout the world. Today, in the liturgical calendar, it is the sixth Sunday of Easter, which is the annual celebration of Rogation Sunday. Rogation Sunday was a day when the crops and fields are blessed. We can celebrate Rogation Sunday by remembering the blessings that Mother Earth yields, both food for crops and the beauty of nature. Today we pronounce God's blessing on the crops that they might be fruitful. Sun, rain, the germinating of seeds, all are seen as blessings or gifts that flow from God. They are signs of God's loving provision, loving gifts to the earth and to the creatures who will consume them. We are removed from the farms and the sources of our food these days. Although there is a movement to foster community farms, to grow locally and buy from local growers vegetables and fruit. And here I think there probably are a few more home farms than there might be elsewhere because you can have such a nice long season. Until fairly recently, I didn't do much gardening. We didn't really have house plants or a garden when I was a child. And I do not have a green thumb. I often forget to water the house plants, and they don't seem to like that too much. Having my father, Lord Eric, living with Daniel, my husband, and I helps.
He is an avid gardener and quite knowledgeable about plants. He has inspired both his son and I to work on our gardens. Even I have done some planting, some weeding. I'm hoping to start composting again, although it is a bit harder here than it was back east in Long Island. It really is so neat to watch as seeds begin to sprout, plants to take root and begin to grow, to see life in vibrant, extravagant displays of colorful flowers, and the rich smell of our herbs, and in the many subtle shades of green. It does not happen instantly. It takes time for a garden to flourish. Time and God's loving blessing of sunshine and rain. God, our mother's gift of life, we nurture it through our efforts, providing life for insects, worms, bees. And from the vegetable garden this spring, we have been nourished already and will be again later this summer. God's gifts seem to bear fruit in so many ways. God's gift of love is like that, like a garden. There are so many shades of green and beautiful colors, sights, and smells. And that gift of love given to us in Jesus, and which we call to abide, bears gifts of love from us to others. As God's love grows in us, it takes root and bears the fruit of our gift of love to others. There's great variety in the garden of God's love that we share. There's the blessing of sharing food with those in need. My family contributes a monthly donation to the Southern Arizona Community Food Banks. And I'm sure there are those here in St. Peter's who donate money or food to similar programs. The gift of time with someone who is lonely or who's homebound or in a hospital nursing home. It's been hard in this last 13 months. Many of us had to rely on phone calls or video calls, if learning that maybe for the first time. Some bear God's gift of love to those in prison. There's God's gift of love in being open and understanding to those around us. The gift of loving and forgiving when we're offended. God's love is like seeds scattered extravagantly on a fertile field. It will take root in and around us and in the world around us. It is self-propagating. And with a little help from his children, we who tend the fields, it yields an even greater harvest. So let us abide in God's love in Christ. And let us not be just receivers of God's gift of love, but those in whom God's love bears much fruit for others.
We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten and not made, but one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation,
We have spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
We are to love one another as Jesus loves us. Knowing God's love and affection for us, let us pray to him now.
I am the good shepherd, and I lay down my life for the sheep. The Lord is our shepherd, knowing his care for us. Let us pray. For all who shepherd others as bishops and pastors, especially Justin, the Archbishop of Canterbury, Michael, our presiding bishop, Jennifer, our bishop, Christine, our supply clergy, our wardens and vestries, and all the people in their care, for Christians threatened and under attack, and all whose ministry feels demanding, for a great affection and care for one another in the church. The Lord is our good shepherd. We pray for all in positions of leadership and influence in our world, especially Joseph, our president, Doug, our governor, all legislators and judges, that they may use their power for good, for an increase in our concern for one another across all barriers, and for all who are working to build community. The Lord is our good shepherd. There is nothing we shall lack. We pray for those who are wandering, lost and aimless, with no idea that any good shepherd exists. For those who die unaware that they are precious and valued by the God who loved them for being. We pray for the sick of this parish, especially Kay, Michael, Michelle, Mike, Marge, David, Teresa, Ronnie, Jobeth, Diana, Ron, Mary, Cara, Sharon, Bertram, Patrick, Walter, Billy, Heidi, Sierra, Jean, Phyllis, Michelle, Marlon, Colin, Barbara, Corwin, Colleen. You may add your own petition here, silent or aloud. We pray for all whose lives are closely linked with the armed forces, serving at home and abroad, that they may be protected from all harm. The Lord is our good shepherd.
There is nothing we shall lack.
We pray for all those who celebrate their lives with birthdays this week, and those celebrating wedding anniversaries, that the Good Shepherd will lead them always to refreshing waters. The Lord is our Good Shepherd. We pray for those who have died to this earthly life, that the Good Shepherd, who understands what it is to die, may bring them safely home. The Lord is our Good Shepherd. We pray in thankfulness for your shepherding of us, and own you as our good shepherd, in whom we kept safe forever. Mercifully and ever living God, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Savior Jesus Christ. Amen.
We remember
O Lord, open those who are living and those who have died. We thank you, God, for their presence in our lives and for the gift of their love. Well, God, we thank you for the power of divine love and for the presence of your love in one another. Have us all finally into that greatest love which Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Once again, thank you for worshiping with us. We have a visitor or some visitors today. If you wish to stand up and announce yourself, you may do so. If you don't feel like doing it, that's okay too. We welcome you. So.
Hi, we're Sue and John Marcus. You can tell us apart.
My name is Lionel. Thank you for allowing me to worship with you guys this morning.
Of course.
Well, thank you for worshiping with us. We do have a birthday that happened this week. So I'd like that birthday person to come forward for a birthday prayer, or if there are any other that we do not know about, please come forward for a prayer.
I know he was shy about standing up, which is not easy for him. But strengthened in this corner is my father-in-law, Eric Snyder, who's a retired priest from the Diocese of Bethlehem.
Oh.
And a member of the church. He can be company, but my husband's away.
We also ask those who are traveling, if you're traveling this week, to come forward.
Any anniversaries?
If you cover it, thank you.
The prayer, if you want to follow, we'll have. Oh, perfect. COVID has been a pain. We usually have the Book of Common Prayer in the queue, and you just refer to it. But it is from the Book of Common Prayer. I'll take it out. Okay? Oh God, our times are in your hand. Look with favor, we pray on your servant Penny as she begins another year. Grant that she may grow in wisdom and grace, and strengthen her trust in your goodness all the days of her life through Jesus Christ our Lord. And the blessing of our Lord, your Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, be upon you and remain with you always. Amen.
We ask you to continue to follow us on Facebook and on YouTube. Service is taped or recorded on Tuesday evening prayer at 6 p.m. On Thursday evening, company at 6 p.m. You can find us at www.stpetersepiscopalcg.org. Thank you. And I do have a little bit of good news that you guys might want to hear. Mother Christina and I had a meeting and we're thinking strongly that we will have 10 o'clock service starting at
May 23rd, Pentecost?
That's right. May 23rd, Pentecost, we will do 10 o'clock service in-house. And since we are up to 50% capacity, we invite you to invite your friends, but of course to let us know that you're bringing your friends, because we still have to have safe distancing. So we need to know who is coming so we can prepare. Thank you.
Thank you. Walk in love as Christ loved us and gave himself for us to bring an offering and sacrifice to God.
Thank you.
our service on page 6 with the Great Thanksgiving Eucharistic page, Eucharistic Prayer B. If you're following at home, send the prayer book to page 367. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give our thanks and praise.
It is right and a good and joyful thing always and everywhere to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. But chiefly are we bound to praise you for the glorious resurrection of your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. For he is the true Paschal Lamb, who was sacrificed for us and has taken away the sin of the world. By his death we have destroyed death, and by his rising to life again we have won for us everlasting life. Therefore we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, who forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name.
Holy, 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 holy Lord, God of the Father and the night, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
We give thanks to you, O God, for the goodness and love which are made known to us in creation, for the calling of Israel to be your people, in your word spoken through the prophets above all, the word made flesh, Jesus, your Son. For in these last days, you sent him to be incarnate from the Virgin Mary, to be the Savior and Redeemer of the world. And him you have delivered us from evil, and made us worthy to stand before you. In him you have brought us out of error into truth, out of sin into righteousness, out of death into life. On the night before he died for us, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread. And when he had given thanks to you, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, take, eat. This is my body which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me. After supper, he took the cup of wine. And when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sin. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me. Therefore, according to his command, O Father, we remember his death, we proclaim his resurrection, we await his coming in glory. And we offer our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving to you, O Lord of all, presenting to you from your creation this bread and this wine. We pray, you gracious God, send your Holy Spirit upon these gifts, that they may be the sacrament of the body of Christ and his blood of the new covenant. Unite us to your Son in his sacrifice that we may be acceptable through him, being sanctified by the Holy Spirit. In the fullness of time, put all things in subjection unto you, Christ, and bring us to that heavenly country, where we give the blessed Virgin Mary, blessed St. Peter, and all your saints, and enter the everlasting heritage of your sons and daughters, through Jesus Christ our Lord, the firstborn of all creation, the head of the church, and the author of our salvation. By him and with him and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory to you, Almighty Father, now and forever.
Amen.
And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say,
our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever.
Hallelujah, Christ our Passover sacrificed for us.
Therefore, let us eat the feast. Hallelujah.
communion prayer is on page 7 of your bulletin. Let us pray. Gracious God, we give you thanks for feeding us with the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ. May we share your body, live with it with life. We will drink this cup, bring life to others. We will the spirit life, give life to the world. Keep us firm in the hope you have set before us, so that we and all your children shall be free, and the whole earth live to praise your name. We cry our Lord. Amen. God the Father, by whose love Christ was raised from the dead, open to you who believe the gates of everlasting life.
Amen.
God the Son, who is bursting the grave, has won a glorious victory, giving joy as he shared the Easter faith.
Amen.
God the Holy Spirit, whom the risen Lord breathed into his disciples, empower you and fill you with Christ's peace.
Amen.
The blessed God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you now and forever.
Amen.
Amen.